The microwave oven I have has all of a sudden stopped working. You see there is just no power here. So I can press on any button. Nope, no power. And it is connected to the power supply. If you can look up here, it is connected. This is Whirlpool microwave model number WMH32L19AS. So I gotta figure out what's wrong with it. Power supply, I see it's still connected. I gotta go check the circuit breaker, see if that has tripped. Here is my main circuit box and microwave. It's its own connection. So from below, it is 1, 2, 3 and the top one. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, I got 2. So top one, I'm gonna turn off both of them. And I'm gonna wait a couple minutes or more and push it back to on. More than 2 minutes have passed. So I'll go ahead and power on the circuit breaker. So that was the third one from the bottom. So I'm gonna push it on the left and turn on the circuit breaker. Microwave, it's usually its own separate circuit breaker of 20 amps. So we're good. Now we'll check it out. So the circuit breaker is okay. The next thing I gotta check is if the fuse inside the microwave, if that has gone bad. Before I check the fuse, I'm gonna unplug the microwave from the power supply. To access the fuse, I'll have to remove this section here. So there, for this model, there are some screws here on top. So I'm gonna remove these. Where's the other one? Right here. Get the screw out. The other one. With both screws out, I'm just gonna grab this and remove it. The fuse is behind this section of the microwave. I gotta be real careful. There's a capacitor inside. And it can be very harmful. It stores electric current. So first I gotta remove the screw here and the two screws at the bottom to access this section. The panel of the microwave is gonna lift up a little bit and then lean forward. I gotta put the camera down. So I pushed it up a little bit like this, and then you see it's gonna now lean forward. So let's pull that out. So that's our fuse right here on the back. We see on the left-hand side. I'm not gonna touch anything yet. There's a capacitor you can see right here. So I want to make sure that the current is removed from the capacitor. And again, check in that it is not, microwave is not connected to the power supply. To remove current from the capacitor, we're going to use a screwdriver like this, which has a plastic, some kind of a rubber or plastic handle. So we're not touching the metal. And with the metal part of the screwdriver, we're gonna touch both terminals of the capacitor. So I'm touching the top and the bottom terminal at the same time. And If you're not able to do it this way, then the other option is to take two screwdrivers like this, two with the plastic base, and then just touch the metal portion of the two screwdrivers together as you're touching the capacitor terminals. It's like a make a kind of cross on those. Okay, so touching this, good, good. All right. We will use nose pliers with insulated handles to remove the fuse. Use the nose pliers to reach in, grab the fuse with the nose pliers, pull the fuse out of its socket, and remove from the microwave. If you look at the fuse closely, on the corner it says 20 amperes, 250 volts. That is the fuse we want. We can buy it online or at the local store.
This is the one.
So grab this with the nose plier and I'm gonna pop that into the fuse socket here. So there we are. I wanna see if I can do this with my phone still on. So align that top horizontal and pop that in. Yeah, it's in. So before I close the microwave, I'm gonna insert this here to test it out, see how it goes. Ooh, sound of success. I like this. And I can see that this is back on, which is pretty good. So microwave is working. I'll close everything else. Thanks for watching.